that I was rooting against him, but Maxey making his way to a 50-point game. Plenty of time to do it. Springer now guarding George. Man, he's all over him. Now the switch. Carson's got it. Oubre on him. Five to shoot. Markkanen goes right over the top of Springer. And it goes, and he's fouled. Got him on the elbow. He got cross-matched. And the seven-footer Markkanen, a chance at a three-point play.
And B.A., that was a play similar to what Dallas used to run for Nowitzki. Kind of post you up there at the top of the key. He's 7 feet tall. You're not going to be able to do anything. And Springer, little contact on the arm. Three-point play opportunity here for Markkanen.
Last year's most improved player in the NBA. First-time All-Star a year ago. An All-Star snub this year, at least for now. Sixers by a point. Under five to go. Sixers have lost four straight. Springer looking for Bamba. A little unsettled here. Now late clock, 2-1. Here's Harris, tough shot from the baseline. Tobias Harris, a smooth operator.
I mean, kind of a broken play offensively for Philadelphia. Great defense, but Harris bails out the Sixers.
26 points, back-to-back games now. Collins goes right through the Sixers defense.
And that was smart. I mean, attack the closeout for the easy two. And really, right now, whoever gets stops is going to find a chance to win, as Nick Nurse calls a timeout there. But that last possession, B.A., Tobias Harris, clock running low, gets to his spot, fadeaway, knocks it down, and Collins drives to the rim. Woo!
And he will draw Tyrese Maxey duty. Sixers ball with the lead. Brian Anderson, Grant Hill, Stephanie Reddy. Got a good one here in Salt Lake City. Second by doubleheaders. Mo Bamba goes to work using that size on John Collins.
And taking advantage inside. Nice play diagram in a timeout. And right now, getting stops here for Philadelphia. A must, as Utah has found a rhythm here offensively.
Bullet pass to Fontecchio, and he comes up short. Bamba with the rebound. Interesting, the lineups on the floor. Sixers dealing with all the injuries. Bamba getting the clutch minutes here. Springer shakes Collins. Springer, no. Markkanen the rebound. Here comes Utah, down three. Dump it inside. Collins. And Bamba there closing with another block on the crowd. Collins saves it. Somebody's open. Clarkson fires. No. And Fontecchio runs down the board. Another offensive rebound for the tie. Lauri Markkanen squares it at 117.
NBA, that possession there. Utah just outworked Philadelphia. Hustle plays, getting loose balls, and Markkanen rewarding them with a three.
Oubre in the corner, missed it. Markkanen another board. He's got 14 points this quarter. Overall, a double-double, 28-10 for Lauri Markkanen. Sexton gets a switch. Oubre's on him. 2.5 to go in regulation. Jazz can take the lead. Springer falls down. Sexton makes him pay. Timeout, Nick Nurse.
Spectacular with 10 games this year, 25 points, 10 rebounds at 11 with his play thus far.
See if the Sixers have a response. This is the biggest lead of the game for the Jazz. Oubre missed it. Collins with a rebound. Approaching the two-minute mark. Utah by three in the ball. Jazz with two timeouts remaining. Sixers have one left after Nurse took the timeout a moment ago. Sexton leaves him with the left hand. Oh! Kelly Oubre! What a block! Maxey pushing in the corner. Bev passed it up. Pat Bev looking for help. And now Maxey will get it set. Tyrese Maxey, 46 points. 4-3, Maxey got it! 49 for Maxey, and his first made three since early in the second quarter, Grant. Clarkson answers, no!
And what a big time three right there for Maxey. stepping up, giving his team a chance here down the stretch, B.A.
Maxey sitting on 49, a 50-piece. No, it's in and out. Thought he was fouled. Approaching 1 minute. What a game. Tied at 120. Clarkson drives. Cut off. Markkanen. No. Harris poked in the eye and a foul on Fontecchio. In this one. First play in franchise history with those numbers across the board. 7 plus 2, 3, and free throw. Beverly guarded by Collins. This is the matchup they want. Harris taking on Fontecchio. Now Beverly open. Cash! Pat Bev puts the Sixers back in front. Sexton drives. The speed dribble. He's fouled. Colin Sexton on the attack. Goes to the line. Down three.
Is on this team. Leadership, confidence, defense, unafraid. Big time shot there from Patrick Beverly.
He's taken two threes. He's made them both. One more fouls to give. Sexton hits them both. A 1 point game. Tyrese Maxey sitting on 49 points. His fourth 40 plus point game of his career. The third this year. Sexton all over him. Maxey trying to shake him. Shot clock down to five. Maxey gives it up. Oubre! Oh, denied by Collins! And a foul! John Collins called for the foul. Natalie Sago brings him up. Oubre will go to the line.
And they might review this because that looked like a clean block.
Upon review, Collins legally gets to the ball and blocks the shot, and any contact after that is marginal contact. So the challenge is successful. The play is being overturned to a no call. In the immediate aftermath of the play, the ball is loose, so we'll be resuming play with a jump ball center circle between any two opponents in the game at the time. And Utah loses the timeout.
Collins and Mo Bamba coming right down to the finish line. Second of our doubleheader. Bamba wins the tip into the hands of Maxey. Shot clock is off. A lot of contact here. Harris now. Sixers knowing that a foul has to come.
5 seconds left. A lot of time off the clock if you're Utah.
Sixers with Harris. 2 point lead now. Trail is Harris in the clutch. Parries two free throws. Sixers by three. Olenek the trigger man. Bamba defends. Need a three here. Clarkson, and he's fouled quickly by Harris. Smart foul. Jazz coming off a 2-4 road trip.
Now they've gone small here, Utah, so they're not going to miss it on purpose. They're going to try to score and then foul right away.
Clarkson puts it up, scores it. Out of 50. Point game in November, and all the way to Maxey. Wow, close.
That was
Sexton
close.
Sexton almost ran that down. Maxey is going to the line.
In the event he makes two here to get a 3-point opportunity for the Jazz.
This for a 50 piece. Got it. Maxey, clutch. 10 of 11 from the line, a career high 51. Last chance for the Jazz. They have time. Clarkson down three. Oh, he's fouled and not on the shot.
I think it was the right call.
Yeah, I do too. And Clarkson now has to miss this one. Player missed it, hit the rim. Oh, look at Pat Bev with the rebound. And the Sixers grind one out on the road. Snap their four-game losing streak.
Hands all night long. They put an extra man in defense. Backdoor cut. Wiggins off the pass from Giddey. And we are tied at 110 on a beautiful out of bounds. Barrett is the inbounder. All kinds of pressure. Ball goes into Barnes. Back to Quickley. Quickley back to Barrett for the three. And we are going to overtime. And Mark Davis getting everybody set at center court. Pirtle sends it back over to SGA and Quickley, but it'll be Toronto with the first possession. Couldn't get that pass because Lou Dort was fronting them as Trent leans in, and Trent has been big for Toronto all game long. He's got 16. Defense had to make a play on the final possession of regulation. They did so on Quickley. Pirtle off the catch and floats it up and in. And so the two possessions here for Toronto gives the Raptors a 114-110 lead. Holmgren, that three is good from the outside, and OKC will take that.
Yeah, man, I like that. That's just a quick to pay for it.
Quickly. Oh, he stops, pulls back, tough shot. Emmanuel Quickly, what a step back. What's so important in the comeback. Shea, little off balance, Quickly makes his move. Bryce Barnes didn't try to do something. Quickly drives in, deflection, and looks like Aaron Wiggins got his hand on there. But misfired from three. Defender still trailing by three. Shea keeps the dribble alive, knifes in, and scores with a left hand. What a move.
Little fakes at him. Put in that spin cycle.
18 points, another double-double. Pirtle, floater, and that one cashes in. Boy, Quickly starting to do some playmaking.
With the finish by Pirtle.
Holmgren lost his balance and tried to pass it out to the perimeter and lost it. Dort. And a little pressure in the backcourt on Quickly, trying to get the ball out of his hands. But Quickly has been manufacturing a little bit of everything here in overtime. Came off the bench for the Knicks. Now playing a ton for the Raptors. Barrett, that shoulder into the body of Dort. That's going to be a foul on Lou Dort. So he leads. Bring Schroeder back in. And it's still trailing, though, by three. The double team on SGA. Giddy with the drive. Back outside. This is what the defender doing. Multiple actions. Shea, step back three. Got it. And we're tied at 118. Slick move from SGA, who's now got 21. And we get a timeout by Toronto. In exchange and blows this entire fourth quarter in overtime. And once again, we got a tie game. Front of defense. Trying to force a miss and a rebound. Quickly back in the game. Barnes has been completely invisible here in the fourth quarter in overtime. Shea with the steal. On the deflection, able to keep it from going out of bounds. And waiting for his teammates to get back into play so they can run something good. And Shea gets to his left. Stops, pulls up, tough shot, no good. Pirtle the rebound. And Toronto's going to have a chance here with the shot clock off. Thunder do not want a foul. And Toronto's going to burn its final timeout. Quickly set up the Barrett three on the previous last possession for Toronto. This time it's entered into Trent. Barnes with it. He has been completely quiet. Over to Trent. Toronto's got nothing going. Trent, tough shot, fading to his left. It gets blocked by SGA. Double overtime we go.
At Paycom Center.
And Quickly, off of the win from Pirtle. Pirtle is blocked on the backside. Chet was able to recover just enough.
And Pirtle thought it was goaltending, but I thought Pirtle took a flat shot that made it easy for Chet to block that shot.
Toronto keeps putting so much ball pressure on SGA. Getting the ball out of his hands yet again. There's that double team. Dort's going to let it fly, and Lou Dort's able to bank it in from deep to give the Thunder the lead here in double overtime.
Okay, thanks. What a time to knock down a shot to put the Thunder ahead by three.
Oh, and Barrett wheeling around with a vicious flush.
This is not his place. This is a Thunder's home game.
Yeah, he's not getting the home bounce anymore.
They're not going to give it to you twice.
See that double team looming. Holmgren this time. Holmgren's going to hit from the outside.
And the way this game has been going, that's a massive three by the rookie Chet Holmgren.
22 points, four threes. Quickly. Trying to scoop it up, but Barnes, the offensive rebound, Quickly wide open, takes an extra dribble. That's how much time he's got, and Quickly doing a little bit of everything for Toronto in midway through this double overtime. Giddy in a really tough spot. Has to float it all the way to the backcourt to Holmgren. He wants to drive on Pirtle, got tied up. Dort once again. This time will drive on the portal and finish over Jakob Poeltl. Lou Dort did not settle for the three.
New pair of shoes on it, almost like he didn't want to take the shot. I thought it was shot short by at least a foot.
Shea saw the double team, able to shed it. Schroeder right on him. Holmgren looking for another three. Not that time, but a back tap out by Kenrich Williams. Shea fires it over to Wiggins. Wide open sideline three. Aaron Wiggins hits another massive three. Toil with this Toronto Raptors team.
Well, now he's just going to try to get a stop here. Just to stall their offense even more. Nice trend. That's a good job, man. That's a working man's rebound by Chet Holmgren. Very elegantly stated part.
And now already with a 7-point lead, can apply a ton of pressure, but Lou Dort fumbled it right off of his foot. Schroeder the other end, and Dort was able to recover. Gets the block, but a foul on Dort.
Wow.
Been putting it all out on the table in the fourth quarter in overtime. Still with the 5-point lead, even after those two free throws from Schroeder. Going to get the ball out of SGA's hands and letting Dort bring it up the floor. As Giddey floats it back out to the perimeter as we get under a minute. The double team comes. Wiggins has to fire for the ball fake. Wiggins, no. And it's tapped out to Trent. So the Raptors get their stop on the other end. Barrett quickly, one of those fast break opportunities for the Raptors. And it's a one possession game.
They still got to bring the contact to you. You just need another score here. And not allow the Raptors to get a quick bucket as they just did in transition.
It's Giddey initiating. Josh Giddey keeping the ball in his hand, slicing through the defense. Got up for the and one.
You know, we were just talking about all you need to do is score because you're trying to protect the lead right now.
3-point play. Season high for Josh Giddey now with 24 after the and one. And it's back up to a 6-point lead.
You know, quickly, he's going to try to take a three here. Instead, he goes.
Trent off the offensive rebound, no good. The rebound to Dort. And with a 6-point lead, the center can put this one away. Shea down low, got around him, and that'll do it.
Wow. You talk about playing smart, hard-nosed basketball in the second half to basically take this game away from the Raptors after being down by as much as 23.
Ball's going to pop out. Out of bounds. They're going to say that's it. It took almost an hour.
Hornets bench has matched and surpassed everything the Lakers have gotten off their bench. 30-26, Hornets lead the bench point. James, he's got his uniform number. It's time for him to try and take over down the stretch like he's done his entire career. Look at that long arm of Brandon Miller. He covered a lot of ground after he picked the ball up. Stitching.
Lakers have done this about five consecutive possessions. He's rolled the ball in, and they bleed about 5 seconds of game clock off. Starting to annoy me.
Yeah, starting to add up.
8-point game. Reeves. Clank. Here come your Hornets. Who wants to make a big shot? Tapped around. Cleared by Hachimura. That would have been huge. I like the gumption that Brandon had. That's wonderful basketball. LeBron James finds Davis at the rim for the fourth dunk of the night.
The switch, and then Davis keeps Miles on his back after the switch. They've done that their entire time they've been teammates with the Lakers.
Oh, Brandon Miller felt the push on the back. Good ball. One more coming from Miller. Darvin Ham tried to ice him. Come on. 8-point game. We're dreaming big dreams here in Uptown.
Stop here. Go a long way. Try to run that same play.
Oh, just ripped it away from him. Just tuck it. Oh. Wildest saves the day for the Lakers. Miller's got the last six for the good guys.
Don't set a screen. Just get out of the way. Or go to the next hottest guy.
Miles with 36 gives it up for Miller. Oh, my goodness! Home Diddley-Dee!
Oh, wonderful execution. Throw that ball to Miles on the post. That's just a decoy.
Timeout because of the beautiful stroke of Brandon Miller. He tied up the net. 30 points in 31 minutes for Brandon Miller. He's got it right now.
Come
on! Matches for the rookie!
What, Brandon Miller, he knows how to accept confidence.
LeBron James with another and one. His fourth and one of the night. Lead extends back to seven. Everyone in the building with eyes on Brandon Miller. Including Anthony Davis. Shot clock's down to four. Bridges. Score the goal with a foul. This is the most important free throw of the night thus far. It is a 4-point game. New career high for Miles Bridges. 39 big ones.
Yes, there is Hornets fans in this building.
You betcha. Old man River. Shot clock down to four. Legs. Oh, my goodness. No. No damage done. Here come your Hornets.
Set it.
Miller has two men on him. Tapped out of bounds. Last touch by the Lakers. In the most important part of the game, he's been hotter than a pepper dipped in fire. Miles Bridges. Shot clock down to nine. Tough. Exit was blocked by Davis.
Got a piece of it.
Anthony Davis blocked a 30-foot three-pointer. That is what difference makers do. He's one for one on the day, 86% on the year. Hornets don't have any more timeouts, so they'll quickly head the other way and try and get something good up on the rim. Reeves doesn't hit the rim on either one of those attempts. Ish in a hurry. Moving faster than a small town rumor. Brandon! And that was clean! Hornets get it back! This has got to go. And now it'll be all she wrote. A reach-in foul called on Ish Smith, trying to poke it away from Anthony Davis. So the Lakers are going to take the two games of the regular season series from your Hornets. A little bit of window dressing for Miles at this first 40-point game. He's going to finish with 41.
And rolls down three. Edwards. Crowd wanted to push off. Gotta be careful. He picks up his dribble. Got it back. 60 seconds. Edwards. Kick out. Towns extra pass. Conley under the basket. McDaniels to Towns again for three. Cash!
cojones.
Big cojones right there.
Crowd on his feet at United Center. Shot clock winding down on DeRozan. White to deep. Brick rebound, Gobert. 2 second differential, shot clock and game clock.
You want to hold this one, wind it all the way down.
Eight seconds on the clock, tied up at 115. Edwards penetrating, Towns long range, can't hit. Battle for the ball, Caruso tied up.
Foul on that situation.
It almost was. DeRozan has a number of game winners on his resume. Caruso finds DeRozan. No good, and we are headed to overtime.
Definitely in Chicago's favor, 16-9. It's one of the stories of the game.
DeRozan taking the bump from Rudy Gobert. Just the second foul on Gobert, and DeRozan will shoot free throws.
11 of 12 for DeMar DeRozan in this game at the free throw line. See Rudy Gobert put his right hand on the shoulder of DeMar DeRozan.
He's one of those guys that you just can't touch, because as soon as he feels you, he's going to make it known that he's touched.
100%.
He's long been one of the best at getting to the free throw line. That's his 13th attempt of the night, with one more coming.
22 of 25 for the Bulls. 16 of 22 for Minnesota.
DeRozan at 38 minutes on the night. He is third in the NBA in minutes per game. Gave Chicago a 2-point lead. Towns over to Gobert. Spacing, not what it needs to be. McDaniels will have to fire and does not get it off in time.
Minnesota spacing, you're right, it's been such a problem here. It's been clunky offense for sure.
.117, .115. Kobe White on the 33-point night. DeRozan has 25. Looking for daylight. Good contested scoring anyway.
Caruso has been locking Ant up, and they've been helping.
Towns taking the contact. No. The putback.
Something he's very comfortable in. Alex Caruso has just done a phenomenal job. He's only one of five in guarding him pretty much on his own. But this Chicago shell concept has been air.
Edwards. He's been quiet since the monster first half. Driving.
Did a great job that time on a switch, going at Kobe White as Caruso was coming to trap him. He went right around him and got to the hoop. Brilliant job by Anthony Edwards.
DeRozan running right through Gobert. And Gobert was paying attention to that right foot. 2-point ball game. Setting screen for Edwards, turning the corner, kick out. McDaniels for three, no good. And Drummond is fouled from behind by Gobert. Drummond took a shot.
Shot goes up. Drummond just anchoring himself, and Rudy Gobert really hits Andre Drummond in the face.
Gobert now with three fouls.
It's the DeMar DeRozan show out here with Kobe White for sure.
Vucevic over to Drummond. Oh! blocked, and he still put it down.
Holy cow.
4-point lead again. The strength from Andre Drummond.
Adding him to the starting lineup has been huge for this team.
No doubt about it. Wolves need to make a play. They turn it over.
Get back on defense.
DeRozan. Fouled. 4 games under .500. Ninth place in the East. Trade rumors swirling around.
They put the heat on Anthony Edwards. Sometimes the best medicine is second side action for Ant.
Towns, kick out. Edwards for three. Boom!
You know, they go to Ant initially here, but sometimes going away from him and then coming back to his side, make the defense shift. Get him on the second side when he's got a little bit of space. You give him the basketball right away, it's tough for him. Man. Not had an answer for Andre Drummond in this game.
Edwards penetrating in the lane, and they're calling an offensive foul. Four-point game. Anderson on the floor for defensive purposes. Wolves with one timeout. Bulls have two. DeRozan over to Vucevic. Takes the three. Can't hit. Anderson taps it over to Edwards. Edwards down the lane. Blocked by Caruso, and a foul is called.
After review, the challenge is successful. It is a no call. The imminent possession is Caruso blocked the ball out of bounds. Therefore, it'll be Minnesota's ball on the baseline with 20.3 on the game clock, 20 on the shot clock.
Edwards to work it in. And Gobert over to Conley. Clock winding down. Conley firing. And they're calling an offensive foul.
Legal screen on Rudy that time, trying to free Mike up.
Critical call, and the fifth on Gobert. Again, Chicago for the second straight game battling back from a deficit. They did so on Saturday, but they ultimately ended up losing. But they cut a 30-point lead down to three against the Kings. They erased a 23-point deficit tonight.
The third quarter wasn't much better either. I mean, they got outscored 36-23 in the third quarter, so.
Both Minnesota and OKC, 35-15 on the season. Chris Finch calls his final timeout. Edwards under the basket. Blocked by Vucevic, who secures it. And the Bulls will dribble out the clock. 38.9 for Edwards, 33 for Towns. But it was the defense that got away.
3-point range. Golden State by three. Curry drives. Nurkic shuts him off. Allen in pursuit. Pajemski finds Green. Dangerous pass, but gets it back. Shot clock at two. Pajemski has to put it up. Falling away. It's good. Brandon Pajemski, a 3-pointer. 9 straight points. And it's a 6-point lead. Durant on the pull-up. Got it. A soft touch from Durant on the rim. 25 points Durant. 4:20 remaining. Kuminga goes right at Bradley Beal. Comes up short.
Bradley Beal is big and strong.
Booker gets inside but can't get it to go with the left hand. Beautiful move. He thought he got pumped. Grayson Allen. Now on Curry. Green and Curry play catch. Curry fires straight on. Booker a three-pointer.
knocks it down. Devin Booker, and it's back to a one-point game.
Jemski. Draymond Green falls and is fouled. And Nurkic just stares at him. The two of them battled all night long, each given the two small signal after a bucket.
You see Draymond make this move quite a bit. It looks like he's thinking dribble handoff, but instead a little, I'm going to attack the rim because I've got one guy to beat.
It's only the second team foul. Meanwhile, the Warriors have only one team foul here in the fourth. Green gets it, goes inside, throws it up, and Kuminga throws it down.
Mike, the youth that they're playing changes the entire feel of this group.
Bradley Beal gets into the paint, has to go back to Allen. Thought about it, but the defense closed. Six on the shot clock. Allen the drive, and deflected out of bounds. Was it kicked?
Yes, it was. It'll be Phoenix ball.
Yeah, but if it's kicked, they should reset the shot clock. It's 4.6, so apparently it wasn't. Beal inside to Booker. Booker up top to Durant. Three-pointer. Short. Curry the rebound. 3 minutes to go. And a three-point lead for the Warriors. Curry off the bounce. Gets inside. Kicks it out in the corner. Wiggins to Draymond Green. Green sees an opening layup, banks it home. Timeout, Phoenix.
It is no coincidence their play has risen since his return.
10 games, they're 6-4 in those 10 games, and the defense has really taken a big bounce. Says Booker counted and a foul. Booker once again had a chance for a three-point play to cut it to two.
I don't know how he shoots his basketball. He actually lost control of this on the way to the cup. So you send him off a high screen, you give him a long runway to beat whoever is in front of him. Screens from both Beal. He did. He lost the ball. Takes the contact and makes the shot.
And makes the free throw. 26 for Booker. Back to two with 2.5 to go. Phoenix came into this game tied for the second best road record in the West, fourth best in the NBA. And fighting here, Draymond Green, another layup. Saw the opening and took advantage. Big buckets for Green. Booker gets inside, layup, he banks it home. Back and forth they go.
One you expect. I mean, you expect Devin Booker to be aggressive. Draymond Green is just saying, if you're not going to consider me a real threat, I'm going to show you what a threat I am. He's 7-for-9 from the floor.
Curry's got Durant on him. Pajemski comes free. Kuminga calling for it. Back up. Pajemski gets a good look. Three-pointer. No good. And Booker the rebound. Booker drives past Kuminga, stops, leans in, short jumper, got it. Devin Booker taking charge, and we're tied again.
This guy is big, he's strong, he's always on balance, and his elevation point is ridiculous.
10 of his 28 here in the fourth. Green to Curry, long three-pointer. Back of the rim, Durant the rebound. Seeks out Booker and gives him the ball. Booker shake and bake. Wiggins stays with him. Booker crossover drives, pulls up, kicks it out in the corner. Bradley Beal. Beal pull up jumper, puts it in. Phoenix back up by two with just over a minute remaining.
So many shot makers.
Curry off the bounce, gets inside. Layup is up and good. A little circus shot from Steph Curry.
That is a big-time tough matchup for Grayson Allen.
We're all tied with 47 seconds remaining. Booker searching for an opening. Gets past Pajemski. Stop, pulls, falling away. Got it! It's a Booker barrage here in the fourth quarter. And Phoenix up by two. Pajemski, Kuminga, Curry, Green, and Wiggins for Golden State. Curry gets free. Durant chasing him. Curry off the bounce. Inside pass to Kuminga. Lays it up. Blocked by Durant. Kuminga misses the second. Beal the rebound. What a rejection for Kevin Durant.
and a held ball.
Well, they take away the lob, but by taking away the lob, they got the switch to Durant. And yet somehow Durant...
Booker. Curry picks him up, four to shoot. Grayson Allen. Somebody's got to shoot it. Gordon throws it back up top. Beal just gets it off in time. Side of the rim. Curry the rebound. Final seconds. And a timeout called by Steve Kerr with 2.8 remaining. Pajemski has it. Here come the screens. Curry comes free. Gets the ball. Puts up a three-pointer. Bang! Steph Curry nails the three-pointer with 7/10 of a second remaining. Allen has it inside. Ball poked away by Wiggins. It's over. Or did they call? They called a foul. But there's the foul to give. Oh, this will be a very interesting call. So they call the foul on Wiggins. Clearly, we couldn't hear the whistle. And they're going to review it.
Play. Upon review,
so we can sit here and say,
illegal contact,
well, I think the foul is here. Mark
after
Davis
the ball
is
released. Ugly. And with 1/10 taken off the clock, reset the game clock to 0.6. There was a foul to give. It will be Phoenix's ball. Free throw line extended on that side.
In the corner, Grayson Allen has it. Lob it inside. Durant has it. And that's it. Now it's officially over. Draymond Green deflects the final pass in. And the Golden State Warriors hang on and win a thriller.
Jalen Green coming to the scorer's table. We'll check in. Spin, shot, miss, follow, second effort, Amen Thompson.
This is not an accident, man. Amen Thompson is so good at hitting the glass. He uses instinct and his athletic ability to hit the glass at the right time.
Great size, explosive leaper, 13 boards, 8 points, career high in steals.
Well, what's even more impressive is that the coaching staff said, hey, you know, forget the three-pointers. Go hit the glass. Go get on the boards. And he's excelled.
From the elbow, Brunson knocks it down. He's got 23.
Yeah, this has been a different Brunson than we saw in the first half.
To Shingun, working on Hart. There's the double. There's the triple. DeBrooks has to. The three. Got it!
Love how much stronger Shingun was with the basketball and accepted the double team.
5 threes now for Brooks. He, too, has 9 of the quarter. 20 for the game. Rockets have 5 guys in double figures. There goes Hart. So Green here on Burks, comes around the Shingun pick, goes back to him into the lane, got there too strong.
He just got to take his time. There's no size in there.
Bogdanovich, no, the reset. Rebound, Jalen Green.
It's probably the best look Bogdanovich has seen in a while. He's hit a lot of tough shots.
Blocked, Achiuwa with another block.
No, Amen Thompson came out of nowhere.
Yep, forced the miss.
This dude is special, man.
Brooks is open, corner three. Corner three, number 6. He's made 6 triples tonight.
Keep talking to him. Whatever they're saying on the bench, just put Dylan Brooks over there and spot him up.
.101-96 inside of 2 to go. Bogdanovich, the swing, Hart, the drive. Back across to Burks over Green. Got it. His first make of the game.
So we got a good ball game here.
Yes, we do.
for the Rockets. Stay aggressive. You got the mismatch inside with Shingun. Cut and be available.
Dillon has tied his career high in three-point makes with six. Shingun, offensive foul.
Yeah, Knicks elected not to double-team, and they've been going all night.
Stay tuned to the Rockets post-game presented by Jack Daniels. Less than 90 seconds to go. Rockets holding just a two-point lead.
You're trapping to make somebody else beat you, not named Brunson.
Burks, no. Tapped out. Brooks has it.
Brooks playing it safe.
Crowd rises to its feet here at Toyota Center. Inside of a minute to play. Shingun working on Achiuwa. Backs him down. Backs him down. Steps through. Puts it into the hole.
Again, you see the feel from Shingun. Right back to him. That's still the mismatch. And Tibbs not double teaming. Dillon Brooks three-pointers making him stay home.
Brunson will drive. And he gets it to go. 25 for him.
Right back to him. Shingun's got to finish or make a good play. Rockets need another bucket. Can't get content.
And Bogdanovich called for a foul.
Content. The men's going to check out for some scoring. Shooting. Alpi wants it in the middle. This is much harder to double team when he has a live dribble.
Achiuwa, by the way, 17 rebounds and a wedgie. Couple of blocks for Achiuwa. Tap, one by New York.
Got to get a stop here.
Brunson on Brooks. Stepping back, contested. Two, ties the game at 103, time out.
Here's the ball game.
8.3 to go. Holiday looking to get it in.
Oh, wow.
Over to Green, a bit of a dangerous pass. Working on Achiuwa. Goes baseline. Comes on the other side. Had it blocked. Holiday picked it up. Threw it towards the rim. And it almost went down. They called a foul. They called a foul on Brunson.
How fitting. Holiday was called for a foul. Was pulled back. It's an in regulation. There's a foul call as Holiday heaved it.
Prior foul is under review to see if the illegal contact occurs prior to the game clock expiring. After replay review, the illegal contact occurs with 0.3 on the game clock. Three free throws, 0.3 of a second on the game clock.
Derek Fisher hit it with 0.4, right?
Oh, yes.
Derek Fisher hit the shot with 0.4. So here's the thing. You get all three, and they have to get a three up. If you just make two of them, the lob... You miss on purpose, yes. And the lob would be live, but...
He got the first, throws it up, made them both.
Yeah, just miss this and just run clock. You see, he may say, miss it, miss it, miss it.
One more. 0.3 left.
Wow. Aaron Holiday, man. Yep.
That's it. Wait. They're going to give a timeout to New York.
I mean, goodness.
The prior play is under review for a clock malfunction to see if the game clock goes to zero. After replay review, 0.3 comes off the game clock prior to the timeout. Therefore, the game is over.
Oh, it's over. The game is over.
Why not?
Wow, it did look like there was some time left. They say, nope, no time left. Rockets win.
We are all tied up. 108-108, 5:19 to go in the fourth quarter here in Phoenix. Booker out of the timeout. Off the hands of Durant, out of bounds.
See if the Kings can continue this momentum here.
Each team has turned it over 11 times. Fox with O'Neal. Now Monk gets a touch. Sabonis working against the versatile Okogie. Sabonis! No answers from Phoenix as Sabonis hammers it home.
Now remember, no real size other than Kevin Durant on the floor. No Nurkic. He's on the bench. No Eubanks on the bench. So Sabonis being able to get wherever he wants in the paint.
Durant connects. That ends an extended run. It was 12-0 before the KD bucket.
62-40 advantage. Points in the paint for the Kings. Oh, wide open.
It's Barnes, and he drains it.
Well, we'll score this in that first half, but Barnes has come alive here in the second with 9 points.
Kings have made their last five shots. Durant drives in. Banker, no, but a foul, and he sprawls out along the baseline.
Sabonis dominating that paint area. Now you're bringing back size.
So it's Allen, Durant, Nurkic, Booker, and O'Neal, the five on the floor. Murray, Barnes, Sabonis, Fox, and Monk for Sacramento. One out of two for Durant. Phoenix is now 23 of 29 at the free throw line. Kings lead by one. Under 4 minutes to go. Here's Fox. Knock away Nurkic. Fox recovers. Shot clock is down to four. Harrison Barnes off the heel. Long rebound to Booker. Booker stops. Gives it up on a skip. O'Neal takes it in for the slammer.
Nice job there by Nurkic, basically playing a fullback. He just kind of boxed out Sabonis so he couldn't rotate over.
Monk! Oh, the scoop goes down! Malik Monk! How do you do?
Did you see that? How low did he go to get that off the rim?
Durant answers.
Never gets old.
Walking, breathing bucket.
Never gets old. And I hope people appreciate this. What we're seeing from the Stephen Currys and LeBron James, Kevin Durant. Look at this.
Monk gets upstairs off the feed from Fox. Back and forth we go.
22 now off the bench for Monk.
116 to 115. Kings. Booker. He's got it. 117 to 116, Suns. Two and a half to play.
Who's going to blink first, right?
Fox lost it. Allen hits the deck. Fox lost his shoe. Allen slow to get up. Booker. Oh, yeah! Suns lead by three. We approach 2 minutes to play. Monk can't get the three to go, and a long rebound to Barnes. On a handoff, Monk drive, taken away by Nurkic.
More size in the middle now, right? Bigger body, deflection.
Booker taking his time. A minute 42 on the clock, left in regulation. Suns shooting 63% in the fourth. Durant, swing, Allen. The rim, Barnes with the board. Break opportunity.
Boy, you couldn't have asked for a better look there from Allen.
Fox redirects. And
it might have been blocked. That might have been blocked by Nurkic.
Nurkic could have gotten a piece. Booker for Durant. And he did not see Fox. That slide. Fox takes it in.
Look at that.
And it rattles home for De'Aaron Fox. They cut it to one.
You're right. Fly like a fox.
35 for De'Aaron Fox. 1 point game. 1 minute to play in the desert. There's Booker one-on-one with Monk. Six to shoot. Double team. Force it. O'Neal lets it fly. Oh, he's lethal! Royce O'Neal, welcome to Phoenix.
And you want to ingratiate yourself with the fan base? Make shots like that, partner.
45 seconds to play.
There's your answer.
It's Fox.
There's your answer.
A triple for De'Aaron Fox. We've got a 1 point game.
Wow.
The trigger man is Allen. Get it in for Booker. 37 seconds to play. Suns up by one. Booker fires. Yes! The man is a cheat code.
I don't think he cares who shoots first or last, and I think the Suns are hoping there's not a repeat of that.
Off the double, Sabonis gets inside and lays it in.
A lot of contact, no foul though. Now you've got to see if you can come up with the steal, but foul.
There's a half a second difference. Shot clock to game clock. Allen is fouled by Fox at midcourt.
They're going to put some more time on the clock.
And a foul called before
the ball's in.
That's the ball was tossed in. A crusher.
That's free throw and possession.
So Booker gets the free throw. The lead is two.
Here.
Get it in. Two-point game. Nearly turned it over. And a foul is called with 15.3 on the clock. Shoot two. Three-point lead. And missed the second attempt. Rebound. This is now a two possession game with 11.4 on the clock. One more for Booker. 25 points, 9 assists. Get it in for Fox. Taking a lot of time. Now he takes it in to cut into the lead, but it's still three for the Suns. Allen is fouled with 3.1. One more
to play.
Meeting remaining. Allen nails the first. Suns lead by five. Late great Walter Davis. Get it in. Fox fires. In and out, and it's over. Suns win a big one at home over Sacramento.
To your teammates and to your gameplay. He's doing his thing tonight so far, trying to lead this Raptors team to a victory.
Seven times this season, he has had a game of 25 points and 10 rebounds, but better. Tonight's one of those seven. First 2 years in the NBA, a total of six, and already a seventh. 1 point game, Indiana on top. Raptors try to go back in the paint. They got 80 points in the paint. Season best performance, Nembhard at the elbow. Pass stolen, it's RJ Barrett. Barrett into the front court. Attacking, finds Scotty. Scotty lays it up and in, and the Raptors by one.
Good pass by RJ, a little off balance, but he found his teammate. And he found his teammate because his teammate ran the floor, ran hard, and got to an outlet spot.
Siakam, double. Halliburton wide open.
It's a bad double match. Yeah. You can't double off of Halliburton. You had the mismatch, but you can't leave Halliburton. The double has to come from somewhere else.
121-119. That's going to be the fifth on Pascal.
Same page on the string.
Quickly, tough bucket. We're tied, 121-121.
Getting downhill himself. Quickly been assisting and doing everything else early in the game. Now he's finding his rhythm offensively, scoring the rock.
Quickly with 14. Siakam backing in. Pascal gets it back. Close out by Quick. Siakam with a move. Puts up a shot, banks it in.
Be Pascal's time. You think he's not ready for this?
He's got 20. Indiana by two. Here's Quick. Gary back over to Scotty. Looking for Yock. Taken away. Halliburton was there.
This is the moment offensively. Scotty continue has to play with force. Do not become passive. Who can score in his sleep, especially on this right side of the floor. And I'm loving this opportunity for Scotty. It's another great opportunity for him to continue to learn how he leads this team, how he finds that balance of being a facilitator and a scorer.
Pascal. First free throw is good. He's got 21.
I'm watching him now encouraging his teammate. Looks like he's talking to Gary Trent Jr. about defensively getting it going.
Pascal Siakam said that, right? It's There's the ups and downs of all this. He's 22 years of age, and what you want to see is a response, and that's what you got tonight. Scotty, off of the miss from Siakam, Indiana by three.
It's all right, now get back. There you go, being aggressive. Now it's going to be a little different. Pascal Siakam's a vet. The game is coming to an end. His defense approach is going to change. He still has five fouls. So now you be patient, and now you pick your spots to try to get him that sixth foul.
Halliburton launches. A rare miss. Loose ball. Siakam with it. Halliburton. Over now to Shepard. Doesn't go. Jakob on the scene. His eighth rebound. Scotty with it as we head to the two-minute mark. RJ, the three, doesn't go. Jakob in a crowd comes down with it. Recycled shot clock. Gary, the three, no. Barrett with it. Barrett, and go to the line. The intensity.
Man amongst boys, look at the flex.
This is the first 4-7 from the free throw line. 23 points, 7 rebounds. RJ really set the tone.
Rebound, rebound.
These are the winning plays. These are the things that have you scratching your head at the end of the game. So you have to complete all of these plays.
Halliburton, Jackson with a left. RJ with the rebound. Scotty, quickly, Gary, corner three, doesn't go, Pirtle there, Pirtle, doesn't go, kicks it out, RJ swings it, Scotty loses it, Gary looks to save it. It's going to be Indiana ball.
Possession game, who are the players who are going to settle your teams now? Is it going to be quickly? Is it going to be Barnes? Is it going to be RJ? Off his leg.
Off of the leg of Halliburton. Halliburton says no, check it, check it. Rick Carlisle was going to challenge that. They called the timeout and then said, hey, we don't want to challenge it because his bench confirmed that it rolled off of Halliburton, so they didn't. Initially, it did appear that the light was coming on and they said, no, we don't want to challenge it. So just a timeout.
About that confidence, just pulling up one-on-one, mano a mano.
They gave him a two on that. They gave Scotty a two.
About that
Scotty trying to take over, wanted a call.
No foul. Yeah,
one-point game.
Solid defense now, Matt. Solid defense.
Pascal, the bucket. Back to a three-point game. Scotty into the front court. And a timeout taken. RJ Barrett to inbound it. Here's Scotty. Screen set by Jakob. He turns, fires three. Doesn't go. Jakob in a foul. So they went for the quick three to tie.
Good rebound. Now he has to complete the two free throws.
Myrtle's got a double-double. First is good. He's got 18 points, 11 rebounds. Raptors 0-7 from three here in the fourth. That's their first made free throw here in the fourth. Comes from Jakob Poeltl. Gets both. Huge.
And you try to go for the steal. If you can't get the steal, you get a trap, and the trap out of the steal out of the trap, then you foul.
1 point game, 14.7 to go. Nembhard. And now a foul, 9.8. It happened right in front of Robert Hussey, the no call, 9.8 to go. Two-point game. Raptors have a timeout left. Jackson misses. Jackson, a 71%. Siakam's return. Hurdle back to RJ. RJ attacking. RJ spinning. RJ with room. Shot doesn't go. And that'll do it. Had a good look.
He's long, he's athletic enough, mobile enough to get there.
What a pass by Garland out to Okoro. Made a great catch to keep it in bounds. Mobley, the turnaround, got it. That's the shot, Doris Burke.
I'll tell you, opportunistic. His whole career, the jump shot has been a struggle. Folks, he's getting better and better and better. And the confidence to take that in that moment, okay, young sir.
A quiet but effective 14-8 for him. Just like his personality. Okoro all over DeRozan. Got a hand up. And DeRozan shot an air ball. Cleveland up one. Mitchell bullies his way into paint and draws the hit.
You know, Donovan
Mitchell was the first one to celebrate it amongst the team and aloud on social media. An engaging teammate and leader. Mike. Good defense by Garland. A little overzealous with the contact, and that's going to put White at the free throw line for two shots. Just a little bit.
Right. Agreed. Agreed.
There was no 70-point first half tonight. Mitchell against Caruso. That's been a nice storyline tonight. Mitchell raises up. And Drummond got the rebound, and a foul is going to go against 40. Garland rejects the screen. Back out top, six on the shot clock, got to get busy. Playing with his food over Caruso. Splash!
Wow. He hadn't been playing the closing minutes until last game because of a minutes restriction. And he makes that shot.
Got 10. Kobe White got an answer for everybody. Ties it at 103. What a night for White.
The young 20-somethings are doing some things down the stretch.
Under a minute to play. White with 30. Vucevic switches on to Garland. Cavs got to like this matchup. They run a double at him. Mobley tried to lob it for Allen. It was tipped out of bounds by Drummond with 4.9 to go on the clock and 43 to go in the game.
Great anticipation by Drummond. Alex Caruso does a great job closing to challenge. Excellent concentration. And then Kobe White's going to return the favor on the other end. Two go to DeMar. He gets off the ball quickly.
Got a whistle and looks like we've got a foul, and if it's before the ball is inbounded, it would be a free throw and possession on the side by rule. Let's wait and clarify and see what the outcome is here.
I mean, he's given as good as he got, though. He's frustrated, wow. But I mean, if the whistle blew initially, fine, because he's trying to impede him. Their whole, but like, that's two guys going for a ball.
Yeah. So we need. Garland retrieves it. Either team with a foul to give. Garland gets Vucevic, crosses him up. The spray, and it comes off to White. Okoro had a clean look. Chicago can take the lead. White, Caruso, Vucevic. White, Vucevic couldn't make the catch. That was coming in a little hot.
Try to make a turnover before you foul.
Neither team with a foul to give. Garland in the backcourt looking at two defenders, and he's a one-man press break. DeRozan fouled him.
Tibben called a foul, so that's going to put down the first. Even if he makes this next one, Doris, it's still a one-possession game.
Tell you what, this young man, Mark, it was only last game that he started to play closing minutes. He talked about how frustrating it was for him. He makes a monster three, and now with the pressure on at the free throw line, knocks down the first.
Talk about minutes limit. Tonight he's played 30. Still getting his strength back. Lost about 10 pounds when his jaw was hard shut. His game is doing all the talking for him tonight, though. Big free throws.
Clutch time points in the NBA to Steph. I know he's not a high-volume three-point shooter, but he's been tremendous in the clutch.
Russo to DeRozan. A lot of contact on that ghost screen, and there's going to be a foul called against Cleveland and Max Strus. So that's going to put Kobe White at the free throw line right there.
Oh, yeah. He chucks.
Like bumper cars
Kobe
out there.
White.
I'm surprised they're not taking a closer look. Not that we need them to, but it's an obvious push there.
No doubt. And with some contention.
Yep. Mitchell back into the ballgame for the Cavaliers. Chicago with one timeout remaining. Cleveland also with a timeout remaining.
You see Caruso trying to get Billy Donovan. He's talking like, can we get Torrey Craig back on the floor, get that extra defender? Vooch gets off the floor. A little smaller, but obviously more active, more athletic, more able to make a quick defensive play.
Knocks down both. And a timeout called by Bickerstaff, an opportunity to advance. They burned their last timeout, a long pass into the backcourt. Mitchell gets it, and he's fouled by DeSumo.
Second time they enter the ball into the backcourt. And wisely, Donovan Mitchell makes himself a target and gets Okoro off the ball. And you get the guy you want at the free throw line, Donovan Mitchell there.
Donovan Mitchell at the free throw line this year, shooting 86%. Doris, you and I were talking about it during the break. I always consider that a little bit of a dangerous pass. Going back towards your own basket.
Little anxiety producing.
Mitchell, 10 of 11 at the free throw line, and now 11 of 12.
Chicago, Cleveland has used their last timeout. Billy has a timeout here.
Still a one possession game, even if he makes this. Rosen trying to talk a little junk to Mitchell there. Rattles it home, and the lead is back up to three. He's got 30, and we're going to stay right here with 4.7 seconds to go. Proficient from the free throw line, 12 of 13.
The MVP conversation isn't only about the scoring. It's about the elevation of all aspects of his play. Again, second team All-NBA last season, J.B. Bickerstaff said, I thought it could have been first half, first team. He's been dynamic. We always knew that about him. Downhill as a driver, worked hard to balance that with three-point shooting, and he has just been electric for much of this night.
Playing the best basketball of his career. Cavaliers need one more stop here. Cleveland up by three. Vucevic makes the catch. Looking for White on the DHO for the tie. And it comes off. Happy Valentine's Day, Cleveland. They win it. 105.
31 points. But missed that time. Here's Zubats to the corner and Powell. He'll rise. And hit the three that gives the Clippers the lead. First lead since early on when it was 11-10. Coming back from a 15-point deficit. Green in the paint. Extra pass by Kuminga. Pajemski. Floater is good. He's got 22.
When in doubt, find Podziemski. That's what I've been saying all night for the rookie. What a big shot there. Great answer.
George, maybe a push-off, and they call it offensive foul. That's five on Paul George. Give him an explanation. No explanation needed, I don't think.
Well, I think he was trying to say he was grabbing his arm, so he was pushing to get him off.
Pass by Curry. Wasn't there, but Wiggins, good defense to break it up. Now Curry for three. Puts the Warriors back in front with his eighth triple and 34th point. 35 threes for Curry in his last four games, one off his NBA record. Harden trying to get past Wiggins. Now on the switch, Draymond Green picks him up. Shot clock at five. Harden penetrates. Ball batted around Westbrook. Got it on the rim. Rebound Podziemski. Curry trying to shake Westbrook. Knocked away by Paul George out of bounds. Will stay Warriors ball with 10 on the shot clock. Franchise history before the All-Star break. Will they stay with 17 losses? Warriors trying to stay above 500. Zubats with the block on Curry. Looked like there was contact, but no whistle. Six to shoot for Golden State. Warriors currently in 10, 26 and 25. Here's Podziemski in the lane. Nice catch by Green and great finish with the left hand. Boy, that was gorgeous from Draymond Green. So after the Clippers took the lead for the first time since midway through the first quarter, it's a 7-0 Golden State run. Zubats finds Westbrook for a nice finish, back within two.
And that's the third time on that Zubac roll. Westbrook cuts backdoor. He's looking for the lob. He's looking for a slice cut right there. The Golden State Warriors have to do a better job of addressing that off that roll.
Curry, too strong in the long two. Clippers basketball, 3.5 on the clock. Kuminga guarding George, bumps him to the corner. Hesitation, and Paul, that's good from Powell. He's hit two from the left corner, among the best corner three-point shooters in the game, and the Clippers on top again by one. 116-115 LA with three to play. Green gets hit by George, and Paul George just fouled out. Six personal foul on George. Minutes total for the game, 7 points for Coffey. And you also take a great defender in Paul George off the floor, along with being the go-to offensive player in the second half for the Clippers. Step back three, Curry is up, comes up short. Kuminga with the offensive rebound into the hands of Coffey, and a foul on Wiggins. And the Warriors are over the limit, so Coffey will shoot on the other end. 115. Seven straight points for the Clippers after the Warriors went on a 7-0 run. Now Draymond Green called for the foul on the screen. That's five on Green. Our weekend next year with the All-Star game on Sunday, February 16th. It'll be the first time the Bay Area has had the All-Star game since Oakland hosted back in 2000. 2.5 to play. Clippers ball up three. Three lead changes in the last 3 minutes. Harden working on the rookie. Great crossover to the corner. Powell for three. Got it! He hit two from the left side. Now drills one from the right, and the lead's up to six. Deadly from the corner. Powell, 5 of 7 now from three for the game. Curry looking to answer. Gets past Powell into the lane. Wild shot, but it's good. Curry, 36 points.
T. Lou talked about his team lacking physicality at their loss to Minnesota. Well, and really at that moment where he got tossed up, that's where his team raised their physicality, and the Warriors have not really been able to answer.
Golden State back within four. Curry's got Harden now. Harden just 6 points here in the half after 18 in the first half. Now Wiggins comes out to take Harden. Five on the shot clock. Harden is double. Step back three. Off the back rim, no. Westbrook hustling to keep it alive, out of bounds, and the officials signal that it's going to be Clipper ball. The Warriors still have a challenge. Hard to tell, and Steve Kerr will not call for time. Warriors have two timeouts left, so do the Clippers. Shot clock at 8, Westbrook to the corner. Now Coffee wide open, that goes down. Everything falling from deep here in crunch time for the Clippers. They lead by 7. Curry driving. Missed the layup, rebound Zubac. That was a big empty possession for Golden State. Meanwhile, the Clippers with 5 threes here in the quarter, 4 from Powell. And a 13-2 run. All of it coming without Leonard. A big part of it coming without Paul George. Curry trying to keep him in it. Hits a 3. That's his 9th of the game. And Golden State back within 4 with 56 seconds left. Curry can shoot you back in it quickly. A foul on Golden State on the other end is Coffee was going 1-on-4, and they still committed a foul. So Thompson, Pajemski, Green, Wiggins, and Curry on the floor. Warriors down 6. Green to the corner. Pajemski, tough angle, but he hits it anyway. Pajemski's 5-of-5 from 3. The Warriors back within 3.
Clay with the big mistake there. The big mistake there. You don't need
the lead back to 5. Curry gets past Coffee, going to get to the rim and lay it in. So it's a 3-point game.
Again, you don't have to foul.
Fans wanted a charge on Westbrook, but looked like a good no call. You Steve Kerr vehemently telling his team no foul as he runs to midcourt. There's a 7-second difference between the game and shot clocks. They'll double Harden. He gives it up to Westbrook with 4. He'll take the jumper, miss it, bat it around. Offensive rebound, Coffee. And now the Warriors have to foul.
Just a mental mistake there by Klay Thompson. A rare mental mistake there for the veteran. You don't need to foul in that situation. Steve Kerr flabbergasted. Klay Thompson understands. This man has played in the biggest games that this league has ever had. He understands he made a mental mistake there, not understanding time and score and situation.
Second free throw good. Warriors will call their final timeout and advance it, but they need 2 possessions and put it in. Here's Thompson, catch and shoot 3. No good. Pajemski missed the tip in, and that's it. The Golden State Warriors 5-game win streak is over. The Clippers stay a game out of first with an impressive road win, their 5th straight win away from home. Kuminga and Wiggins. Steph, Clay, Draymond.
Nice.
The lob and Kuminga. Perfectly thrown by Draymond Green.
It's a step back screen again. He sets those bone-crushing ones. Been calling for those. Kuminga is a weapon. His athleticism, his aerial assault.
AK's 5-of-6. He's got 13. Incredibly efficient. Mark it in 3. They started so poorly. He was sitting there at 1-for-13, but he's working himself into a game with 14 points now.
It's that pick and pop. He might have to get a third defender in there to at least stunt, throw him off.
Steph missing the bank shot. We have the 19-point lead. They're led by 18 beginning of the 4th. Jazz played last night, but they didn't have to travel.
You just lost
your leaking oil here. Leading by 7.
You just lost sight of your man and ball.
What a game by Sexton.
He's got 32. Keontae George has 33. He's working on and off the ball.
Draymond! They're going to call the foul before, and it takes away the layup.
And it's again Steph Curry setting a ball screen. He's setting back screens, setting ball screens. He doesn't care about his scoring. He's only got 12 points. We're used to Steph getting more points, but he's so unselfish.
4th team foul on Utah. Warriors are already over the limit.
He knows he can get other guys involved.
Steph gets Collins on a switch. Curry. He took a bump there, and he will get to the line. And Steph rattles out the 2nd free throw, so it stays at 8.
Warriors are in his zone now.
like a 1-2-2.
Markkanen setting up Collins. Didn't want that three. Sexton with the shot clock at four. He'll pull up at the foul line. Markkanen kept it alive. And then Collins setting up Sexton down the lane. Missed the layup. Another rebound. Battle loose on the deck. Clay's got it. Big defensive standard. Jazz players laying all over the deck.
You cannot.
And then a throwaway.
Over. You cannot.
Up eight there with 3 minutes left. And Markkanen hits a three.
That is massive.
That's the whole story. It's the points off turnover.
You had two Jazz laying on the ground, and you had numbers. You cannot try the toughest pass there. Just make the simple one.
Well, they have tied that season high. The 18-point lead down to five. Draymond, three. All the momentum for the Jazz. Sexton plays bigger than him. Steph nearly had the steal. Keontae George missing that three. Big rebound, Sexton. Sexton puts it up and in.
He's played so big. This is the second best team offensive rebounding. Number one second chance points. You have to come up with these defensive rebounds.
Steph Curry for three. Wow. Single possession game.
You got to quell this momentum somehow. You need stops.
Deontay George puts it up and out. Clarkson the rebound.
Guys are just getting hands on it, keeping it alive for the Jazz.
Sexton driving. Now, Wiggins getting a call for a foul, but Sexton shoved off with the free arm first.
And then they come back and knock down a three after that.
Sexton finally misses a free. One of two from the line. 18-point lead to begin the fourth. Clinging to the two-point advantage. And the Dubs execute. Deontay George staying with Steph. Shot clock at 10. He's fouled.
And
I love that because the Warriors are in the bonus and you put Curry at the foul line.
That's too much from George. He's all over him. I understand ball pressure, but there's a lot of contact there. He's screaming afterwards. It was quite a reaction. And Steph's got a lot of quickness, and he can use that to his advantage if George is going to guard him that close, that far away from the basket. Big free throws.
Steph has missed two free throws tonight. Best free thrower in the NBA. And this one, that one there.
It hasn't been his best game. He's got the 10 assists. He's set some great screens.
Nails the second one. Now it's up to the defense. Season high for threes made for Utah. So they go for a three now. Deontay George.
Oh,
he went
traveled.
Up and down. Traveled. Clay was right there.
Clay switched on to him. Moved his feet, contained. George had nowhere to go. It's a rookie in a high-pressure situation. Turn the ball over.
Enormous possession here. Up three with the ball. Pajemski picked up the dribble. He needs help. Shot clock at 10. Draymond looking for Steph. Shot clock at 5. Clay checked it. He will turn, fade, fire, and rim it out. Markkanen with the rebound. Warriors don't have a field goal in nearly 4 minutes. Markkanen to tie the game. Off on iron, but Collins gets the dunk.
And these second chance points here late.
Now it's set up for a 2-for-1. The Warriors should have two possessions to Utah's one to close the game with a 1-point lead. Draymond to Wiggins. Loose on the deck. Wiggins spilled. Clay at open three. Utah looking for the win. Final 14 seconds. Deontay George driving. Deontay George kicking out to Markkanen from deep. Rebound, Collins. 5 seconds left. Collins throws it away.
to Steph. And he will be fouled right away.
Whew. Those offensive rebounds. Jazz are fighting so hard to get those. Warriors are so fortunate. He threw it into the 10th row. Look. Markkanen misses that one. Warriors are fighting for it. Jazz are using their size to get some of these rebounds and just chucked it. Can you execute it? It's
first
a different story.
First, make the two free throws.
And Steph bottoms that one. On a make or miss, Utah's taking a timeout. Makes them both. Here we go, Kaleta Azubuike. Twice. And Sexton, a three, and the Warriors win! Colin Sexton misses a three. Steve Kerr has won his 500th game as a coach.
Bell for the dunk.
Something we see from our squad with Domantas Sabonis handling the rock. Looking for that movement from the guard. This time,
oh! He put Zach Collins on a poster, framed it, and stuck it on his bedroom wall.
Victor Wembanyama has been on the floor. I think he's only got Domas one time tonight. But Domas challenging him at the rim has been just so critical for the Kings' offense tonight in the paint.
Domas 29-9. Vassell, meanwhile, has 29 points. Wembanyama getting a break here. He only plays about 30 minutes a game or so. All right, we're back underway here. Two-point game. Harrison Barnes, shot clock winding down. Now at 10. Little ghost screen by Kevin Herter. HB, he got it.
They're challenging San Antonio's defense at the rim. Quiet night for Harrison tonight, but you can always rely on him to step up in situations where there needs to be a play made.
HB coming off that 20-point game last week against Denver. Quiet game for him, but they haven't needed a whole lot of scoring, but needed that free throw as it's still a one-possession game. Under four to play here. First game after the All-Star break for both teams. Johnson ties it at 114. Keldon Johnson has 18.
The Kings absolutely have to be able to get consecutive stops. You need 3-5 stops in a row here down the last few minutes of the game to try and gain some separation.
Domas tipped up. Let's see if they give him a rebound for that. I think so. That'll be a 38 straight double-double for Domantas Sabonis. Wembanyama. No. Under three to play now. Sochan being a pest forces the turnover. Wembanyama hacked and one. Wow. HB with the foul. And Victor Wembanyama a chance to give the Spurs the lead.
Since November, in terms of how he looks at the game and how this team has developed and are playing together, and it's because of a rookie that has been able to really lead that charge.
That free throw gives the Spurs their first lead since it was 39-36 at 8:58 in the second quarter. No, Wembanyama, the rebound. He's got 13. Here comes Vassell. Gets caught up in the air. Trey Jones trying to snake the baseline. Shot clock at three. Vassell got it. Big three. My gosh. He's got 32. Kings playing with fire right now, Katie.
Absolutely. You don't want to mess around with this team. They've got confidence. But Malik Monk stepping in, making a big basket to bring the Kings to a two-point deficit here. You have to get stops at this end of the four. You're under 2 minutes. Kings have not been able to do that consistently throughout the game.
Wembanyama catches shoot. right, Kings get one stop. Here comes Malik, guarded by Sohan. Using that Domas screen. Sabonis has to kick it out. Fox, step back, sets the feet. Three, and money for number five.
And thinking about that shot right there, there had to be time for De'Aaron Fox to kind of get his feet set. He knew it was a big one, and he had the time to knock it down. Nothing but net for Foxy.
This Golden 1 Center crowd on their feet for their king. 1 point lead. Wembanyama, no, was looking for a foul. Under 60 to play. Oop time! Keegan taking the oop from De'Aaron.
Pascal, because he's going to be someone they're looking for, but also look for Wimby at the rim.
19 triple-doubles for Domantas Sabonis. 38 straight double-doubles. Here's Sohan looking for Wembanyama. Nice denial by Keegan, but Pascal ripped by Swiper.
De'Aaron Fox with the finger wag right there. Absolutely coming up with a massive stop.
One possession game, however, Fox, fourth quarter time. Yes, sir. Up by five, Spurs out of timeouts. Scoop, counted by Trey Jones.
Last thing you want to do if you're the Kings is foul. If you get the ball back on defensively, have to go up against this Spurs team. But right here, use the clock,
yeah,
move the ball.
Got a foul here.
Getting the steal, knocking down the bucket. He has been fantastic. He's saving possessions. Those are not easy buckets to make, but Malik knocking down the free throw when it matters.
Kings 10 of 14 from the line. Back to a 5-point game. Sohan airballs one, and Sacramento will improve to 32-23 as they begin the post-All-Star break stretch with a lighting the beam ceremony.
Throw your hand up, Drew.
That's why you practice and practice and practice. Kennard unfettered to the rim and breaks the tie. 91-89, 3:29 to play in the game. Clippers just 4 for 16 here in the fourth quarter. Memphis 7 for 13. They outscored the Clippers by 6. Leonard at the foul line. Whistle and a foul. Just the second for Memphis. The Clippers, the next whistle will be over the limit. Just the second foul on Williams.
Got him again. You know, over the summer, I'm going to talk to Vince a little bit. It's the solid defense. Don't go for, not right now, but that time Kawhi able to induce Vince Williams to kind of reach down after the ball and picked up the foul, kind of bailed out the Clipper offense that time over Stagner.
George for three. Bullseye! 92-91. Clippers by one with 3 minutes to play. Clippers out in front by one.
What now we need big-time defense to get multiple stops here so we can grow this lead a little bit more.
Kennard for three in the lead. Misses everything. And Terrence Mann with a rebound. 2:42 to play. James Harden brings it across. Harden runs into Williams. It was just the third foul for Memphis.
Why? Yep. Oh, see, it's coming from the opposite side. See, that's where the official came in. Watch right here. The push. Kawhi did extend his arm, so I thought he was going to get away with it right there. See, from that angle, it doesn't look like it. But from the opposite side, you can see the push a little bit. And the weak side official picked that one up.
Second foul on Kawhi, the 21st Clipper turnover tonight. And they are just 5 for 17 here in the fourth.
Great defense here. Great pressure this time by the Lakers.
Jackson inside, lays it in. Memphis by one. Yeah.
Williams comes out to half court to pick up Leonard. Kawhi for three in the lead.
I can imagine them trying to go back to this matchup here with whoever's guarding Jaren Jackson Jr. right now, way out on the perimeter. Double team.
The crowd getting loud on their feet. Intercepted by Kawhi. It's a foot race. Oh, he thunders it in. And the silence is loud with 1:35 to play in the fourth. Clippers lead by one.
An excellent double team that forced that cross-court pass, and Kawhi timed it up. Zoo is trying to make his entry back in the lineup, and almost a turnover.
Jackson recovers. Spins his way down the lane. Pocket pick by Harden. Coffey. Man, right place, right time. Timeout Memphis.
They are showing their teeth defensively here in the fourth quarter.
Jackson. Fouled by Zoo. He'll go to the line for two.
Five so far here tonight from the line.
He'll shoot to that 82% for the year, so that's an added bonus when your center is shooting 80-plus percent, knowing that he'll have a lot of touches at the end of the game.
One-point game, 107 to play. The crowd again, once again, on their feet. Harden. Coffey back to Harden. Seven to shoot. Under a minute to play. Harden for three.
Oh, yes! Harden knocks it down. And the strings make an evil hiss and silence the crowd.
Jackson. Tough shot. Rebound goes to Kawhi.
Leonard. Terrence Mann with the rebound.
And the Clippers will take time off the ticker.
And earlier, they let time go off the clock. Great for us, but a little clock mismanagement right there by Memphis that benefits us now. It took off about 7 seconds.
What a comeback here for the Clippers. It hasn't been pretty until maybe the last 3 minutes. And I've said before, I like these games for the Clippers for this reason. The experience and executing. And tonight with a different lineup without Norman Powell on the tail end of a back-to-back. But at some point, the Clippers are going to have to play a 48-minute ball game. And as they come down the stretch, 101-95. Need to run through the tape here. Kennard for three. That'll do it. Clippers have it. 4.6 to play. 101-95. In a game that was sloppy for the Clippers. 21 turnovers. They trailed here in the fourth. Battle back. And they win 101-95. Clippers 7-0 going back to.
Sideline out of bounds. Minnesota basketball. Here's Edwards. Off the flare, Cat. This one comes off to Gobert. And another opportunity for Minnesota. Edwards looked to pass it. Get an open lane to the bucket. Here's Karl-Anthony Towns again. Sidestep three. Tipped up and controlled by Crowder. And stolen by Kyle Anderson. Edwards from deep. And Giannis pulls that down. Boy, Edwards had a great look at it. And Giannis on the fly with those lengthy strides draws the hit.
That little routine now where he kind of does a little pantomime with the shot before actually shooting it.
Whatever it takes, whatever it takes, and I stand by that. We, again, don't forget that 50 ball that he put on the Phoenix Suns in the NBA Finals, knocked down his free throws.
Yeah. In the clincher.
In the clincher. So to me, it whatever it takes in those moments, good for you.
Gobert with a nice bit of jelly at the rim. Lefty finish by the big man. He's got 12.
All right, it's a six-point game with 3.5 minutes to go. You're at home if you're the Minnesota Timberwolves. You're in a very good spot. No need to stress. Doesn't matter what your third quarter looked like. It's about closing time.
Dame with a quick sit dribble. Drives it into the paint. Out to Lopez. Retrieves it. Tough turnaround. Three! Butta! Dame Dollar with cash!
Did I just say it's closing time? Well, if it's closing time, then you know it's also Dame time.
That was cold-blooded. Edwards at the other end raises up over Lopez and scores it. He's up to 19 on the meter. Still just a 7-point advantage for the Bucks. Giannis changes gears, threw up a wild shot and drew the foul on Karl Anthony Towns, who's incensed at that whistle. That's
Miller says it's empowering to hear that from Giannis face to face.
Lefty in and out dribble. As Giannis knocks down both free throws to make it 105-96, 2:40 to go.
And Giannis alone is 11 for 17 from the free throw line. The Minnesota Timberwolves as a team are 8 for 13.
Wow. Anderson out front. Good defense by Lillard on McDaniels. Towns inside, caught a body, and punched it home. He's got 22. Doc Rivers imploring his team to keep playing.
Timberwolves got the string together, 3 or 4 stops here in this last 2 minutes.
Lopez thought about it, now pulls the deep three. A little hesitation might have cost him there, Richard.
Yeah, just a little bit of rhythm. Obviously, Rudy Gobert wasn't going to get all the way out there.
There's the rhythm from Anthony Edwards. No hesitation there. Edwards with 22, and the lead is down to 4. Got crunch time minutes here. Less than 5 minutes to go, less than a 5-point lead for either team. And this is the guy the Bucks signed and traded for crunch time. Dame, Dollar, this one long, but they'll have another opportunity. With 1:30 to go, Giannis splits it and draws the foul in traffic.
26-13, this game looks completely different.
And this Minnesota's first of 7 straight on this homestand. Makes 2 in a row, he's up to 32.
This is, if we're weighing these games for the Milwaukee Bucks, this is a big game. This is a very, very big game, a mental game, an emotional game for the Minnesota Timberwolves. This is your opportunity.
Towns with the 3, and 1 and done at the offensive end for Minnesota. Lillard brings it across. The score and clock in their favor. Guarded by McDaniels. He rejects the screen. Dame inside, followed by Giannis. He was pushed and fouled. And Antetokounmpo will get a couple of free throws. Dame a little
likely not going to be blocked out. So great job by Giannis getting downhill, getting that opportunity. Got to box out.
Knocks down the 2nd. 7-point lead.
All right, Minnesota's got to go quick. Now, they got 2 timeouts, so they have a lot of options, but they got to go quick, and they got to get some scores.
And off the pin down, raises up and knocks home the 3 ball to make it a 4-point game. Still a 2-possession contest. Milwaukee with possession. McDaniels with some full-court pressure. Now Edwards picks up Giannis.
Don't want to foul here.
Little run-and-jump trap there. Giannis inside. Crowder got it home. Just in time and a timeout by Coach Finch in Minnesota. His first field goal of the game. Crowder had surgery back on November the 14th. Missed several weeks of action as a result, but a key part for Milwaukee's hopes moving forward. Here's Gobert off the inbound. Edwards takes another 3. Made the last one. 2 in a row. So it's down to a 1-possession game.
Don't need to foul.
They tried to trap Lillard.
Don't need to foul.
Giannis is not the guy you want to have the ball in his hands. Their coach, free throw percentage wise.
Bitch is screaming, no foul. They got to. They weren't communicating very well.
And the play for the stop defensively, Minnesota here. Lillard. Dame time. It's Dame time. Tap your wrist with a simple flick of the wrist. Dame Lillard in his crock pot. He's cooking. 9.2 to go. Connelly into Cat. They're trying to get it to Edwards. He's made his last two threes. This one comes off, and that'll pretty much do it. Lillard with the rebound. And the Milwaukee Bucks with what might prove to be a signature win on the season.
Six, that's all to go in the game. Pistons have it down 109 to 105.
Got
to
be really good. I think the Pistons have down used up any margin for error they may have had.
Simone Fontecchio back to Cade, clock at 13. Judge trying to stay in front of him. Cade spins to the lane, fires, fills it up. Man, what a pro move that was. 2-point game. Cade Cunningham strikes again. Vaccaro to forecourt against Fontecchio. 1:10 left. Orlando by two and with it. Franz Wagner against Cade. Backs him inside, fires from in front. Off iron. Rebound, Jalen Duren. Off to Cade.
Wonder if he's going to give it up or take it again.
Stop and go move, forces a foul.
I believe that's their first.
Suggs got him. They had that foul to give, I believe. Yep.
First in the last 2 minutes. Suggs trying to cut him off because he knows Cade Cunningham wants this. Look at this, George. How tough is this? I mean, he's being hounded.
You're in his office, though. Do what you want to do, but you're going to have a heck of a time stopping Cade Cunningham around the paint. Clock at five. Cade back to the lane. Lobs it. Jalen Duren couldn't touch it down. Carter Jr. has the rebound. 35 seconds left.
That was too 50-50. That was too much 50-50. Even chance for Carter Jr. or Duren to get it. Probably not the play you wanted that particular second.
Shot clock down to 10 for the Magic. 20 seconds to go in the game. Vaccaro to the baseline. Misses. Contact, though. Ready to shoot two with 17.9 to play. Missed the first. Now, let's see what he'll do with the second free throw. Short. Rebound, Jalen Duren.
Wow.
Timeout, Pistons.
That was a chance at an offensive rebound.
Got inbound the ball. No timeouts. Fournier looking. Bounces it to Cade. Screen from Jalen Duren. Cade to the basket. He hits it. What a play. Cade would not be denied. 12.4 seconds left in regulation. All even. Carroll gets the first catch. Backs up near the sideline. 6 seconds. Now five. Now four. Up fake from the baseline. Knocks it down with 8/10 of a second left. Vaccaro, who was ice cold all night, just warm enough here to make a tough, tough shot.
He has all but forgotten about the two free throw misses prior. And as I said, it didn't shock me because he's probably over there, coach, please, please let me have it. And Jalen Duren made him take a tough shot. He made it, and he got fouled.
Well, for the foul, Jalen Duren.
Pistons lose this. This is a microcosm of their whole season. They've had every bad thing that could happen to them all year long. And this just adds to it.
Free throw falls. Can they somehow get a three in the air with 8/10 of a second left to force overtime?
It's going to have to come from a long way, like right here.
Cade lets it fly. Who knows? Oh!
Wow. Wow.
Hit the rim.
But against him, no thanks. Brunson, three-pointer, short. Duren couldn't grab it, but Cunningham able to garner it as they approach the midway point here in the fourth. A five-point Knicks lead. They've been up by double figures several times, but the Pistons keep coming back, led by that man, Cunningham.
He's had some help here in the fourth quarter from the bench, including Grimes. Grimes drives, feet inside. Duren gathers and banks it in.
And the Knicks playing small-ish right now. Again, Mitchell on the bench. Isaiah Hartenstein has said 21 minutes, so we probably won't see him, depending on if they ramp him up more.
Brunson looking for an opening. Double team poked away by Fournier. That's his second steal on Brunson. Cunningham kicks it out in the corner. Grimes hesitated. Now fires away. Three-pointer won't go, and a foul on Bogdanovich. Games and some earlier action. Grimes, three clutch free throws there, and the Pistons have tied the game with 5:22 remaining. Knicks in a real battle against a team with the worst record in the NBA. Brunson guarded by Thompson. Bogdanovich quickly releases. Shot won't go. That's a tough shot. And as we hit 5 minutes remaining, Cunningham. Cross court stolen by DiVincenzo. Ahead to Brunson. Brunson drives. Back out DiVincenzo. Three-pointer. Bang!
These guys are incredible. Just know where each other are on the floor and nowhere to go.
That's the 11th assist for Brunson. Fifth time this year he's in 10 assists or more. Grimes jump shot. Back in the rim won't go. But Duren right there. Bogdanovich had his hands on the ball, but Duren's strength. Brunson looking. His three-pointer. Shot no good. Tipped out Bogdanovich. Back to Hart. Hart has it knocked away. And a foul.
Ton put up a ton.
Brunson. Achua drives inside. A lot of contact there. Shot no good. Kept alive. Taken by Grimes. Under four to play. Fontecchio to Cunningham. Thought about the three. Thompson goes inside. Hartenstein closes. Grimes, three-pointers up. Shot's good. Quentin Grimes gives the Pistons their first lead since the first quarter.
He gives the Knick bench a glare as he runs down the floor. Remember me?
He's got 12 points, all of them here in the fourth. Three and a half to go. Six to shoot. Hart gets inside. The floater's up. Shot no good. Rebound. Achua lays it up and in. More time.
Achua comes in the game as Tom Thibodeau saw the Knicks playing small. Not a good matchup. He went big. Achua and Hartenstein in the game together.
Fourth offensive rebound for Achua. 11th total. 3 minutes to play. Cunningham gets inside. Shot put, won't go. DiVincenzo the rebound ahead to Brunson. Brunson drives inside, stops, hesitates, and puts it in. Timeout, Detroit. Nope, he's not going to call timeout. The Pistons started walking to the bench. And Monty Williams saying, nope, play on.
The players thought it's time for a timeout, and he's like, no, let's go. Plenty of time.
Under 3 minutes remaining. Brunson with 33 points, 11 assists. Cunningham to Fontecchio. Cunningham, he's got 32 tonight. Gets away from DiVincenzo. Steps up, jump shot. Won't go. Hart the rebound.
Cunningham suddenly cold, not making his shots, frustrated with himself.
Brunson, the hesitation, jump shot, puts it in! 35 for Brunson. Knicks back up by four. Grimes calling out a play, asking for a screen. DiVincenzo shuts him off. Grimes gets it back. Up top to Cunningham. Kicks it out in the corner. Thompson a three. That's good. How about the rookie Thompson from downtown shooting 15% from that distance this season?
15% means some of them go in. That one, timely.
Knicks lead by one. Under two to play. Thompson guarding Brunson. Brunson a three-pointer. And Grimes the rebound.
anxious moments here. You can feel the anxiety from the crowd. Minute and a half remaining. Cunningham guarded by Hart. Gets away, lobs it up to Durant. Blocked! Achua and Hartenstein meet him at the rim. What a defensive play.
That was incredible.
Shot clock at five. Jalen Brunson on the drive. Kicks it back out to Hart. Hart, foul line jumper. In and out. Hartenstein battling, knocked out of bounds. Pistons ball. Cunningham, Duren, Fontecchio, Grimes out there for the Pistons. With Thompson, Hart knocks it away. Cunningham being chased up top. Fontecchio, extra pass to Grimes. Shot clock at six. Grimes off the bounce. Running layup is good. What a shot from Grimes. 14 points here in the fourth quarter, and the Pistons lead by one. Brunson looking. Guarded by Cunningham. Fontecchio looking to help. Brunson, three-pointer. Off the mark. Rebound deflected. Chased down. Saved by Grimes to Fontecchio. Knocked away. Hartenstein picks it up. Out to DiVincenzo. 10 seconds to go. He throws it away. Ball loose. Picked up by Brunson. Brunson inside to Hart. Hart banks it in. And a foul. Knicks take the lead. Monty Williams is furious. He thought a foul should have been called. There was so much contact. But Josh Hart with the big bucket and a free throw coming up.
Diving for what seemed to be a loose ball that was right in front of us.
Hart misses the free throw. Saved by Hart. And a whistle and a foul. I think it's before the shot attempt. Won't matter because it's... So Hart now from the line, 3 for 5. Hart knocks that one down. Take it a three-point game. Hart misses another ball. Batted loose. Hart picks it up. The game's over. The next win.
5 to go.
We'll hopefully get this sorted out as Dallas lead is 105-98. Meanwhile, the Cavs need some stops here as Luka Doncic steps back. Loose ball grabbed by Kleba in a crowd. That's a big play there as Washington wheels inside, finds an open Kleba for three, and Max earned that. Kleba has given the Mavericks a 10-point lead.
Wow. Again, offensively, they are one of the best in the league. And when they beat you inside for rebounds and things like that, it just makes them that much tougher.
The Mavericks run is 10-0. That ball comes loose to Allen. That's a big bucket right there. It escaped the grasp of Irving. And Allen was the recipient. Mavericks 108, Cavaliers 100. We approach the four-minute mark.
Opportunity now has to be for the Cavs on the defensive end of the floor.
Kleba sends it back to Irving. Irving finger rolls inside. Kyrie now has 25. He and Doncic have combined for 70 of the Mavericks 110. Struce. Back it goes to Mitchell. Takes a bump from Hardaway. Struce fires a three. He knocks it down. Kleba came out with a contest, but Struce finds his third long-range bomb of the night. And oh, boy, Irving stepped on the baseline, inbound into basketball, so it's a Maverick turnover, and believe me, the Mavericks have been really clean with the basketball tonight. That is only their fourth miscue of the evening.
And that's one of the reasons why they've been able to stay in control of the game, because of that. Oh!
The Cavaliers capitalize, and all of a sudden, that Maverick, a 10-point lead, has been trimmed all the way down to four.
It's amazing how things can change in this league.
That was the Mavericks' first turnover since the 8:36 mark of the second quarter. Irving long range. Oh, brother. Woo-hoo. Irving now has 28 points. He's knocked down 5 triples. Mitchell finds Struce. Struce looks to stay hot. And he does.
Finally open there.
Max Struce
has five threes. Haymaker after haymaker. Mavericks by four. Irving baseline. He got squeezed out. Out comes Mitchell. He'll find Garland. Garland off to Strews. Strews with another. Oh, my word.
Shoot it. Supermax. He's on fire.
Unbelievable. Came in a 67-second span, and the Cavaliers are back within one. 2:20 remains. This crowd is on its feet. Doncic steps back. That's going to be short. And tracked down by Strews. He's been the man of the hour here in this fourth quarter.
You wonder about the Cavaliers' bigs? We have a 7-foot guy guarding Doncic that makes him shoot an air ball.
Mitchell with under two to go. Works on Washington. Garland fakes a three. Dumps back to Mitchell. He'll fire. He knocks it down as Donovan Mitchell has given the Cavaliers the lead.
Moving the basketball was a beautiful thing. Boom. Shoot that ball, Donovan.
Mitchell and the Cavaliers have offered a 15-3 run in less than 2 minutes. They offered a marvelous comeback to shock the Mavericks in Dallas 2 days after Christmas. Here's Irving. He's watched by LeVert. The Mavericks led by 10 just minutes ago. Doncic looks for an opening. He's doubled. Green missed the shot. He tried to draw a foul. Back from the Cavaliers with a 2-point lead.
It's called defense. Exactly what it is, the defense at the right time.
Garland is watched by Doncic. The Cavs have made their last five threes. Garland gets right around Doncic to the basket. That's blocked by Kleber. Washington has his head up. He'll bounce off to Irving. Irving got called for an offensive foul, and it was Max Strus at the point of attack. Irving can't believe it.
Doing a super job of waiting and staying with it on defense. Coming in, he slides off on Irving. Irving hooks on. Right there. There's the foul right there.
Boy, that is a big call late as we are now under a minute to go. The Cavs have the basketball in a 115-113 lead.
New possession opportunity here.
It's knocked away from Mitchell. Doncic, back to Green. We're tied.
Turnover in the backcourt.
40 seconds to go. Garland is picked up by Irving. Mitchell is guarded by Green. Uses an Allen screen. Fires a three. And nails it. Donovan Mitchell as the Cavaliers come alive from long range. Late in this ball game, you see the Cavalier run as with 29 seconds remaining. He has played 38 long minutes. This man, Max Strus, has been a catalyst here in this final frame. Four threes in just over a minute to will the Cavaliers back into this game.
He brought the team back to life with his play. Those four threes have changed the whole feeling of the Cavs, especially on the defensive end of the floor.
The Cavaliers have two timeouts remaining. The Mavericks have one. Irving works on LeVert, gets inside, floats it up and floats it in. That cuts the Cavalier lead to one. You can tell the Cavs there right around that perimeter. They advance into the forecourt out of the timeout. They'll send it all the way back to Caris LeVert. So the shot clock is off. LeVert bounces off to Mitchell. Cavs will play keep away here. Dallas looks for a steal. Garland, he's tackled. Whoa, by Green, nothing was called. And the Cavs take a timeout. Oh, my goodness. Mobley to inbound. The Mavs look to deny. Whoa, that ball's knocked out of bounds. Mavericks ball. Again, the Cavs were out of timeouts. Dallas will use a timeout here.
In this situation, you can't have anybody get an easy shot.
Kleber has that tip by Mobley, but Doncic gets it back. Doncic dumps inside Washington, puts it in. 2 seconds left. The Cavs are out of timeouts. They have to go 94 feet. Strews from midcourt.
Oh! Do you believe this?
Whoa! My goodness!
Max Strus from midcourt has won it for the Cavaliers.
The Cavaliers call up heaven for the prayer and is answered by Superman.
Vucevic. Here comes Cleveland. Another tight Cavs-Bulls matchup down to the wire. It's been Heartbreak City the last seven times these two teams have met. Mitchell, the kick, intercepted by White. Shot clock is off.
You got them behind you?
Whoa, oh, Mitchell knocked it away, and DeRozan recovers it. Woo. A chance for the win.
Gotta go, gotta go, gotta go, gotta go.
Six left. It's DeRozan. DeMar for the lead. No. Off to overtime we go. With Mitchell, but it ends up being a switch with Vucevic. DeRozan tries to get him on Garland, and the rotation led to that Garland look.
Because you had to help Vooch on Donovan Mitchell.
Yep.
And that just made a whole
domino effect. Exactly. Amok Garland, 7 of 12 from 3 tonight. Season high, 7 triples. For a guy who's not shot the ball great this year, but as Stacy mentioned, was dealing with injury early. Vucevic spinning on Mobley. Got it to go.
Good move. Good move by Vooch.
Big fourth quarter and overtime for Vucevic. He's got 24 now.
Back-to-back solid game for Vooch.
Yep.
And if you're the Bulls, you got to avoid these switches.
Yeah.
Can't switch. You got to be straight up.
Because that's what Mitchell wants now.
Right here.
Yeah, he wants the switch. Good job by Dosuba to stick. Strus. And DeRozan. Good job by Vucevic to deter.
Got back in there.
Batum up ahead. Dosuba. Vucevic drives on Mobley again. And that's picked off by Garland, but he couldn't squeeze it. It's a break for the Bulls. Right idea by Vucevic, but he's frustrated at himself because I think maybe he thought he should have just taken the shot.
Here, trying to make a play right here. And he sees, he's at the corner of his eye. He knows Isles in the corner. They know where everybody is. So he thought he was going to make that pass over there. Cleveland with those active hands.
DeRozan has played 42 minutes tonight, the league leader in minutes played. Kobe White's number two. Drag step, kick to Batum, two on the clock. Batum hangs and will not get it to go. His first miss of the night after being put into a difficult spot late in the clock.
I wanted to shoot that three. Just let it go.
Would have been tough here in that corner, though, against Mitchell.
Right there, just pull up now. He's trying to get to the basket. Just pull up.
I mean, this is essentially his NBA debut. I know he appeared in two games for 6 minutes, but in garbage time. This is a real debut. He had to leave to go to Strus, so that opens up LeVert again, and the Bulls are on a rotation for another trip.
Yes. Got to stay true defensively here in overtime. You cannot get caught off your man.
Here's Dosuba. Got it.
Niles woke up on offense.
He's got 11 points since the start of the fourth quarter.
All right, let's stop it. You got to stay true.
Because you're trading threes for twos now. Yeah. You need stops.
Here comes that big screen. They're putting Vooch in the pick and rolls.
White trying to stick with Garland, but Vucevic switched.
Oh, no.
Garland dancing with Vucevic. Did he knock it off of him? He did. Credit to Nikola Vucevic, who stood in there against Garland.
I'm telling you, that's still a tough defense right there.
It is very tough.
If you're Billy Donovan, if you're putting him in that screen, I'd just go blitz him. Blitz him, get the ball out of his hands. You can't keep Vucevic out there switching. They're running it every single time.
DeRozan to tie it. Vucevic tapped it. Whistle, and it's a foul. Vucevic, and he is fouled out of this game.
Wow. Did DeMar get fouled?
Here it is. Depends on where Strus and when he made contact. Called Vucevic for that foul over the top.
Let's see.
Hey,
Again, that's it. That's tough.
At the end there, too, maybe Struess with a hand on the wrist of some or something. I know that's what DeMar was looking for. So Vucevic fouls out, 24-13. Drummond is back in with 15 points and 21 boards, and you can see Vucevic's frustration.
Well, it's not over. You got to get up and play some defense.
44 seconds left, and the Bulls are down. A massive situation needing a stop. Mitchell sees the clock, goes to work, and scores again. Late in the game, when you need a bucket, no matter how quiet he's been for three or maybe even four quarters, Donovan Mitchell knows when to come up and deliver.
Well, you see the difference now with when Vooch is in a game, they want to put him in the pick and roll. Vooch is out the game, now they go guard to guard,
yeah,
switch, and now we want to get the matchup that we want on this end with Kobe White. Here it is right here, opens up. And right now, and somebody's got to go. Somebody's got to help him. Because you got to remember, this is an all-star caliber player.
At 8:30, Bulls down four. DeRozan drives and scores. Two-point game with 21 seconds left. J.B. Bickerstaff screaming for a timeout. They'll use one of the two remaining here, and they'll advance the ball. On the foul situation here.
See if they go to LeVert in the backcourt.
Cleveland the bonus. Here's Garland in the backcourt. Running clock. LeVert, Struess, Mitchell. Precious time taken away. They got about 8 seconds off the clock there. Short. Drummond with the rebound is 22nd of the night. And the Bulls still have life.
A one-possession game with a lot of time on the clock. Up to the basketball.
Yep. Bulls out of timeouts. Cleveland has a foul to give. Dosunmu to inbound. They get it to DeRozan. Forces it up and it gets fouled by Jared Allen.
I told you. J.B. Bickerstaff has to be right now. Three free throws. He's got to be scratching his head or rubbing his head. He doesn't have any hair, but rubbing his head because this is not what you wanted here. You wanted a foul quick. And there he is right there. That's a clear foul.
It's going to be three shots, as you said, stays clearly behind the line. Wow. So here is DeMar DeRozan, 8 of 9 at the stripe, but he needs all three to tie it.
And that's the one thing in a timeout you had to have been telling your players. Do not foul the three-point shooter.
Especially a three-point shooter, right?
Yeah, because it seemed like he was trying to foul to get the take the foul, but he was too late getting out there.
And DeRozan, the savvy vet, was able to draw the contact at the right time. This is the big one to try to tie it. Mitchell and Garland are back in for Cleveland.
Remember, he hits his free throws. Still a lot of time for Cleveland. They're going to get the last shot.
And they still have a timeout to advance. DeRozan needs this one, though. Got it.
There you go, D-Bo. All right, let's go. Got it locked up.
They will not call timeout. Tied at 115. 3 seconds left. It's Donovan Mitchell.
That's offense.
For the win! No! Double overtime! He got plenty of free basketball for you. Drummond wins the tap over Mobley. White against LeVert, fakes the three. DeRozan drives it instead and reverses it.
Oh, what a move. The marvelous DeRozan. Coming up huge. 26 points, yep. five assists, 9 rebounds.
7 in the overtimes for him now, Stace. Struess, curl, shoot, catch, no rebound, Kobe.
There you go, take your time now. Execution important here.
Bulls' biggest lead was 4. White spins, almost traveled. Got it to Batum, though. Now it's Dosunmu late in the clock. Needs help. Here's DeRozan with 3.
Gotta go.
Forces the 3.
When you need a big bucket, find the veteran, DeRozan.
Warriors, Donyell Marshall, Tyson Chandler, Eddie Curry, and Jamal Crawford.
Oh, man. Wow, you went really deep there.
Deep into the archives. Mitchell, high arcing. Three is good.
Struce.
Short. And after the Bulls suffer.
26 rebounds?
It's 26 rebounds.
74.
And Leonard with 22. LeBron's hit four threes in the quarter. The second time he's made four triples in a quarter. Anthony Davis was on the bench during that run. He's back out there now. He got Powell on LeBron. Shot clock at five, and now Harden switches out. This is what James wants. He gets past him. He drives. He hangs. Missed the shot. Got it back. Goes up. Flips it in with the left hand. James, 31 points. That's his 13th 30-point game of the year. And a foul called here as Terrence Mann hit the deck. They get James for the foul, his second. Clippers led by 21, seemingly moments ago. It was this quarter, but great run here by the Lakers to get back in the game. Mann in the paint, missed the shot. Davis got the rebound. Five and a half to go. Lakers ball down five. James, 12 of 17, 6 of 9 from three. Mann takes him on the switch, and now you get Harden on him again. Again, the matchup LeBron wants. Shot clock at eight. James gives it up, deflected by Powell out of bounds. Six to shoot. 16 to 10 here in the fourth quarter to pull the Lakers within five. They have five to shoot. Reeves steps back, fires to Hachimura with one. He's got to put it up. Lets it fly on the baseline. And it's short. Rebound Powell. James Harden, 21 points, but the bulk of that came in the second quarter. Gets aggressive here. Missed the runner. Gets it back. Out to Powell for three. Misfire, rebound Davis. 10 rebounds for Davis to go with 18 points. Now James with Tice on him backs up to the midcourt line. LeBron rocking it. Step back, three on the way. Bottom! LeBron James with five threes here in the quarter. Lakers within two.
How many times have we seen that signature step back three, hang dribble with the left? Oh my goodness, LeBron James, what a quarter.
19 points, his highest in a quarter this season, and he just knocked the ball out of bounds off Kawhi Leonard. LeBron James has taken over the game here in the fourth quarter on both ends. Lakers looking to tie or take the lead. LeBron coming to get the ball. Davis with the screen, so they switch Tice onto James again. LeBron fires away. Missed it that time. Offensive rebound, Davis. And fouled on the putback try. A chance to tie it at the line for AD. They've erased a 21-point deficit in about 6 minutes here.
The fifth three of this quarter for LeBron James. There's that signature move. And Dave, on the other end, in this quarter, he's taking the challenge. He's matched up directly with Kawhi Leonard. Previous possession forces that turnover.
First time in 4 years that LeBron has hit five threes in a quarter. He's got 34 points now. 19 in the fourth, the most in any quarter this season. As he continues to make the push towards 40,000 points. He's now 40 away from that. They play tomorrow night against Washington and then Saturday on ABC against Denver. AD ties the game at 106 with 4 minutes to go. Who will have the answer for the Clippers? Kawhi Leonard, guarded by James, drives past him. Goes around and almost turned it over. Deflected out of play by Reeves. 11 to shoot for the Clippers. Harden to inbound. Got to call a timeout or get it in quick. And he throws it away. Turnover by the Clippers. Lakers can take the lead as they erase a 21-point deficit in 8 minutes. Thanks to LeBron James.
Year 21. Never take it for granted, Dave.
It is just amazing to sit here and watch. At age 39, year 21, the NBA's all-time leading scorer. Bring it when it matters most. They switch Tice out on him again. Shot clock at 10. Now they double. James forced to give it up to Russell. Hachimura open for the lead. No good. Davis got the offensive rebound. Back out to James. Shot clock at 8. James driving on Powell. Kicks it out. Hachimura again. Finally, the Lakers have the lead, overcoming a 21-point deficit here in the fourth. 109-106. Clippers looking to answer, 3-minute mark. Powell lost it, now gathers, shot clock at 3. Powell has to hoist. Poked away, Reed. Powell gathers and fires, and it's a shot clock violation. Now the Laker defense starting to step it up here.
And this is LeBron just making the right basketball play. Help off the strong side corner. You got Hachimura over there shooting over 40% from 3. That's the right play.
Davis sets the screen, forcing the switch. Tice on James with a shot clock at 10. Now man comes to double. Corner, look again for Hachimura. This time he drives. Reverse layup, good. 5 Rui Hachimura points. Gives the Lakers a 5-point lead. A 12-0 run. Starting a critical stretch of the bulk of their games at home, this would be a huge comeback win for the Lakers if they pull it off. They're outscoring the Clippers 34-10 in the quarter. James Harden finally gets the Clippers a basket. And it's a 3-point game with 2 to play. 23 for Harden. James with 34 on 19 shots. Shot clock at 10 again. Tice on the switch on James. Shot clock down to 5. James gives it up to Reeves. Good look for 3. Can't hit it. Davis had it, lost it. Tice hustling, gets on the floor, but he rolled out of bounds. And it's Laker ball.
Good hustle here from Tice, but just no one to pass to. And eats the ball.
New shot clock for the Lakers. 90 seconds on the game clock. Leonard switches out. So Tice on James again with a shot clock at 15. They bring the double. They work it around to Hachimura. LeBron gets it back with a timer at 8. And now Harden switches out. Shot clock at 5. James to Russell. His 3 is good. And the Lakers lead by 6. It's contagious. It was all LeBron from deep early, Hachimura and Russell late, and it's 114-108 Lakers.
This is catch high, keep high. D'Angelo Russell, no wasted motion. Nothing but the bottom of the net tells the crowd to be quiet.
19-12. Simply amazing what we are witnessing. Bringing the Lakers back, although Leonard with a basket out of the timeout, the Clippers still in it, down 4, just outside a minute to play. James had 15 points through 3 quarters, took 1 shot in the third. Every shot he's taken in the fourth has fallen. 7 of 11 for the game from 3. Timers at 5. James, step back 3. No good. Rebound man. Clippers ball down 4. Hachimura picking up Harden at the 3-point line. Here's Leonard. He'll drive. Layup good with the left hand. Clippers back within 2. 12-second difference in the game and shot clocks. 114-112 Lakers. 12 to shoot, 24 in the game clock. Leonard on James. LeBron driving, falling away. Missed the shot. Rebound Harden. Clippers can tie or win on this possession. T. Lou will not call a timeout. 8 seconds left, and now Lou will call it. 9.3 on the clock. That's the Clippers' final timeout. LeBron James defending Kawhi Leonard, who catches and drives. Clippers down 2. Fall away baseline. Short. Great defense, James. Gets the rebound. Ahead to Reddish with the exclamation point. What a comeback win by the Los Angeles Lakers. And it wasn't just LeBron on the offensive end.
made a great play defensively on Kawhi Leonard to knock it out of bounds when the Lakers were down five, and then got the stop on the final possession against Kawhi.
We've got a bad mismatch here. Kuzma goes into the middle.
Now there's Kuzma outside, and Washington has the lead. 121 to 120.
He had the advantage, but I didn't think he had it from the three-point line.
Lakers up against it. D'Lo, 15-footer. Again, a team with just 9 wins. And been reeling. Kuzma on the outside, just hit. Kuz all the way, the hook shot is good. Little running hook.
He had to throw up the hook because he knew that Anthony Davis were lurking.
How about LeBron coming back in? That was a half a minute. AR all the way, got it! Tough shot for Austin. Get back, play a little defense.
He's barking at the official.
Each team with 2 timeouts left. If this extends a little bit, you're going to see a Laker timeout just to get LeBron back in the game for sure. Got to get him back in. With 3, with 2, Kuzma. Boy, they put him in a no-win situation. But for the Lakers, that's a good stop. It's a great stop at this point of the contest. Reeves, some nifty moves. Here's D'Lo for the lead. Well, Bagley was in a wrestling match with AD.
That's a good box out by Bagley. Let his teammate go get the rebound.
Yep, he and AD are holding on to each other. 1-point game. They hit a 3 here. It's really nervous time.
If they score here, it'll be nervous
time. Yeah, it'll be 3-point. Underneath Jones all the way. I think he wanted to lob it. Instead, he shot it. Now the Lakers with a chance to get the lead right back. Dinwiddie. Reeves fly by. So LeBron does get back into the game, as mentioned. 123-122. Minute 8. Clock's moving. James. Davis. Lakers lead it. 124-123. Again, each team with a couple of timeouts.
Under a minute. This is the stop you have to have.
Lakers have a foul to give. Washington out of fouls. Crowd on its feet. Poole on its way. Got it! Jordan Poole. Wow. What a huge bucket for them.
You could see him setting up the step back there.
Wow.
You watch these players long enough and you know what's coming.
He's got 34 big points. LeBron all the way. Blocked by Bagley. Out of bounds. 34 seconds left in the game. Bad pass. Oh, the Lakers so fortunate.
Well, they have to score, obviously.
It goes right to Reeves. Got to get into your action. There's 7 to shoot. Reeves doing just that. Bagley over Bagley. Austin for 2.
This game right now is in the Wizards' hand. The clocks are out. The game clock is the only thing that's operable. Worst thing that can happen for the Wizards is overtime.
Been put to bed. 126 all. Lakers trying to survive for an overtime with 4.
Yeah, about it for the long distance shot.
Don't rule out Kuzma here either, but here is Poole. Jordan Poole to win the game. We're going to overtime. With that 12-game losing streak, trying to get the double digits in wins. Lakers somehow trying not to just drop the ball so many ways in a game they should win. Reeves, AD, alone on the wing. First possession of the extra period, and down goes D'Lo to score.
So often you see guys just turn their head, especially when LeBron or AD have it, and all you have to do is dive, and that's what D'Angelo did.
Bagley. Kuzma open. 3. Yes. Kuz for 3.
Again,
nobody near him.
No communication again. You know, you have to talk to each other. You can't just assume that you know what your teammate is going to do.
bounce. Davis, pull up. Well, that came up short. Short on that a little bit. Thought maybe he was going to use glass. Now Kuzma, he's got one thing in mind. Get to the rim. The stew special, as he says. Kuzma to give them a three-point lead. Again, Poole had an opportunity. Last possession of regulation. Lakers get a little extra chance. LeBron going big minutes again tonight. 35 plus. They turn it over. Here comes Poole all the way. Oh, LeBron does it again. Blocked by James. Blocked by James.
Got to match up, though. There, they finally matched up. That's some play by LeBron.
Kuzma long distance. Oh, LeBron saves the bucket. 131-128. One of the plays of the game, without question. To tie it up. He's got it. Defense at one end. Hidden from downtown at the other. LeBron. Eleventh time we've been tied. Oh,
away.
You know, Poole's a little frustrated. He was the one who had his shot blocked by James. 2 minutes and 45 seconds.
No score here. Obviously, there'll be a timeout, but you got to get the offense in order here. They're just clowning around right now.
Bounce, LeBron, here he goes. Great dish.
Finish, AD. Slam dunk.
Well, they don't take the timeout. 2:24 and counting.
Lakers get 5 points in a row. Take the two-point lead. One way, then the other. Poole, left hand, in and out.
Got it a little hard, but yeah. That was a nice move by Jordan Poole.
Really was. AD was there.
This is stand right now, 133-131.
40 and 14 for Davis. 40 and 14. LeBron, 39 and 4. 30 points, 9. Oh, offensive foul. Gotta be. LeBron takes the charge.
After review, the call on the floor has been overturned to an offensive foul. This is a successful challenge by L.A. They will retain their timeout, and they will get another challenge.
He's helping LeBron take the ball. Oh, here comes AD.
AD.
Your ball handlers are all down on the other end of the floor.
AD would disagree. I'm a ball handler, he'd say. LeBron. Minute and a half to play. Lakers up by two. Hold on. Hang on. They knock down Reeves. 4 of the 5 Lakers starters are in double figures.
Biggs, LeBron, and AD combined for 71.
Oh, rebound, Rui!
Nice job, Rui.
Gives them a fresh 14 and a 3-point lead.
That could be the play of the game.
LeBron, Reeves, turn, shoot. Does not score. Obvious got the rebound. Nothing's even close to being decided yet. In the attacking 47 feet. Kuzma trying to get around Rui. Hands in the air. Had really nowhere to go with it. Stutter step by Poole. It is not even close.
Austin
did a good job on defense.
But you got to make them pay now. You got to score here. You got a 3-point lead with about 44 seconds.
And maybe put it away.
If you score here, you're in position to put it away.
LeBron. Obvi is in front with 5, with 4 on the clock. LeBron's going to shoot it. Here goes James all the way, on its way. No! Tab Reeves!
Now run some clock.
Absolutely. They're going to have to shoot. Remember, it's a 14.
Yeah, but you run some clock, though.
Clock. Yeah,
now you go.
Spinning. Austin gives it to AD.
Off of AD's foot.
Shot clock is off. Shot clock has been put to bed. Jones in now for Poole. He's had a couple of opportunities at the end of regulation here in overtime. It's yet to really convert. Now Kuzma for the tie. They tap it all the way out, but it goes to Rui. It went to Rui, and the Lakers are going to win it. Lakers.